Avant-Garde-Arama, Avant-Garde-Arama, Avant-Garde-Arama. Thank you, my friends, for coming out to Avant-Garde-Arama Returns to the Lace Note. I think we have a really interesting program. We had a great night last night, and we're lucky that we have Nancy Ostrowski back in the house after she was not feeling well to perform with us last night. A few lay of the land issues. The bathroom is through the doorway in the next building to the back of the gallery. There is also seating upstairs if anybody wants to look down on things. The bar is open. All the money's going to the artists and to the lace mill, so please drink up. So I'm your host, producer, and the co-creator of Avant-Garde-Arama. And some of you may have never heard of Avant-Garde-Arama and wondered, what is it? And I thought I would take you back in time to its origin. It was the winter of 1980, and I was living on the Lower East Side on Christie Street, just off the Bowery. And I had just started my own dance performance career after 5 years of working with Robert Wilson and being in the original production of the Robert Wilson Philip Glass opera, Einstein on the Beach. I started rehearsing in various downtown lofts, and then a colleague of mine, choreographer Charles Moulton, a former Cunningham dancer, called me up and he said, I found this new space in the East Village. It's in an abandoned public elementary school, PS 122, on the corner of 1st Avenue and 9th Street. He said, I'm rehearsing there in the afternoon, but use it at any other time and see if you can make something happen. And I got very excited. I mean, yes, I was happy that I could have a place to create and perform myself, but the Lower East Side was exploding with so many creative people in dance, performance art, music, visual art, that I just felt it would be great to do something that brought more artists together. And as I was thinking about this, I had a friend, Jeffrey Isaac. Oh my God, my God. Interruptions. And I went to see Jeffrey, and we started talking about starting a performance festival that would mix all genres of work. Jeffrey, whose alias was Zagreus Bowery, because he lived in a loft atop the Dime Savings Bank on the Bowery. Zagreus said, if you're gonna have a festival, everything has to be short. Because if it's short, you can watch anything and everything. So we started thinking, well, we're going to do this festival. What could we call it? Well, we know the work is going to be avant-garde, contemporary, experimental. But what are we going to call it? Avant-garde. Jeffrey mentioned he was buying his accordion equipment at Accordions-Arama on 14th Street. Arama. Everything in America can be Arama. Wonderama, Disco-Rama, Burger-Rama, Avant-Garde-Arama. Why not Avant-Garde-Arama? So we came up with the name, and Jeffrey Zagreus made the posters, and the first poster was for the first show in April of 1980. And one of the features of that show was, in addition to a number of performances, we created a section of the show called 42nd Street. And in that section, the audience were invited that if anybody wanted to do something, tell a story, do a dance, play some music, they could do it for 40 seconds. I'll tell you more about that later.
Sorry for the interruption.
Oh, the interruptions.
No, excuse
the
me.
Interruptions, okay.
No, I don't. Excuse me. I'm sorry for the interruption. But I'll be right back. I know you've got Avant-Garde-Arama. In fact, this gentleman just came up and thought that, but it's only been 5 minutes. 1 second.
5 minutes interruption.
So,
yeah, continue.
So Avant-Garde-Arama started in 1980. It continued at PS-122 for over 25 years, still is there occasionally. And when I moved to the Hudson Valley 4 years ago, I thought this would be the kind of a great event.
I'm only interrupting.
Oh, because it's time for Gene Taylor's performance.
No, because the information that I'm trying to share is so important.
Oh, okay.
Okay?
Okay.
5 minutes.
Okay, 5 minutes.
Seat him.
5 minutes. Okay. Well, what's so important? Well, I work for the Department of Transportation, the Office of Kindness, and I am the Director of Safety and Personal Growth. I'm here because I'm a flagger. I've been a flagger a long time. I know that. And I'm not sure that the general public, now I'm also apologize, I know none of you is like general, you're unique individuals on your own path. But at the moment, I'm just gonna say the general public, I'm not sure that you know your part of the stop, slow, continuum. The stop, slow, continue. Yeah, it's okay. Good to ask questions. Now my boss says they know. The general public knows what they're supposed to do. Basically leave them alone. But here's the thing, I'm out there a lot. And I don't think you know. So what I'm asking is, just a few minutes, is that let's delve into the possibility of stop slow together. Okay. Ready? Okay, good.
Yeah.
Flagger, pull, paddle, cone, walkie-talkie. All right. Now I'm out on the road. I'm out on the road, and you, you're in a car. I mean, not right this moment, but you're in a car, usually, often, and you approach me. But as you approach me, I get a buzz on the walkie-talkie from my colleague up the road. So then I have to go into my regulation. Stop. This is the gesture from the side. Stop. Now, you're coming along and you see me, and so you stop. I stay in my stop mode, but you have a world of possibility in yours. I'm gonna be you just for a minute. You're in the car, you see me, you stop. What happens next? You breathe. A big one. Oh, good. I hear it even in the crowd. You breathe maybe a second time. Nice big breath. Excellent. Practicing already. So the breath gives rise to the pause. Oh, the pause. And the pause gives space and time for reflection. And the reflection can be a conversation you just had, a pattern you'd like to change in your life. It could be a little reflection on your whole life, but that's up to you. The reflection gives rise to the discovery. A new idea, a new insight, maybe a new perspective. Well, all of that is just too good to lose. So the next step is You have to like integrate. You have to integrate it. Make it your own. Now, my friend tells me that sometimes takes a little while. So you might also want to take a note or a note so you don't forget it, right? But there you are. You've gone from stop, breath, pause, reflection, discovery, and then right then, I get the buzz. And we are ready for the slow. Not go, slow. So there I am. I go into my next regulation gesture. And also I guide you. And I'm giving you some inside lingo. This is called pet the dog. Pet the dog. Pet the dog. And there you go. A changed person. Yeah. Stop slow. So when I see you out there, and you know I will, I now know that we both know our jobs. Thank you. And sir, Mr. Avant-Garde-Arama, up you get to conclude. Thank you.
Traditional is also avant-garde. And please welcome Paul Chambers.
Thanks, I hope I just need a moment to don my official schmuck and get set up. So this is called a geel. It's a xylophone from West Africa, Ghana, and Burkina Faso specifically. I'm going to play some tunes on here that I learned while traveling in said area. First one is going to be a bit of a funeral song. Which is named after these little goblins who, legend has it, were out in the woods one day playing this instrument, and people went up and stole it and brought it back to humanity, and that's how they acquired said instrument. And so this particular song is meant to scare those goblins away, so to speak. Thank you. next one's a little bit more cheerful, I guess you could say. It's from the Dagara people on some more big celebration tune called Bewa.
Thank you.
last one I'm going to leave you with is another more upbeat kind of dancing tune. If you listen carefully, you can maybe pick the out. There's always a very set pattern, melody of a song, and then just kind of going into a more intense solo for the giant mass of dancers who would be circling around me, if you can imagine that.
Thank you.
I'm going to now take off my host hat. And change into my dance clothes. And I'm going to perform a new solo, what I call a dance talk piece. In my early career, in the 80s and the 90s, a lot of my pieces were dance talk pieces, where I wrote things and improvised things and talked and danced together. In recent years, I've been doing a lot of physical movement-based performances, dancing with a stack of 2x4s or a big mound of my plastic garbage. And I just thought it's time to revisit the voice. This is called Dreaming Out Loud. I open my eyes, and I'm dreaming again. I'm letting the thought bubbles. Bubble up from the well of consciousness. Conscious unconsciousness. I'm dreaming out loud. Can we all dream together? I'm dreaming of the past. I'm dreaming of the future. I'm dreaming of things that have happened. I'm dreaming of things that will never happen. Maybe some things that might happen or could happen. I hear a song from the band's first album, and I hear these words. Isn't everybody dreaming? Then the voice I hear is real. Out of all this idle scheming, can we have something to feel? I'm dreaming out loud. I'm remembering that many of us dreamt not so long ago that a new age was going. Of peace and harmony. And I remember that day sitting on a sand dune in Aquinnah on Martha's Vineyard, tripping, naked, with my hippie friends. And we looked out from the dunes of the Atlantic, and we turned around and we looked back toward the mainland, and there was this beautiful caravan of clouds. And those clouds seemed to offer up the promise of something new that was slowly coming towards us. A moment later, jeeps came down the beach with police, and they rounded up all the naked hippies and took them to jail in Edgartown. I was standing outside the police station, which was just a country house in Edgartown with a big backyard, and we were in a line ready to be go processed by the police. I saw some people walk into the yard and start talking to their friends ahead of me. A policeman turned around and said, "Get out of here! These don't you see these people are being arrested?" They started walking away. I saw the policeman had turned around. I walked with them to my freedom. Freedom! The freedom to dream. The freedom to face reality face down. With your ear down to the ground, Jim Morrison said, "I hear a very gentle sound." I'm dreaming out loud. Now I'm dreaming. I'm rollerblading with my recently departed dear friend Frank Boyer along the Ashokan Promenade. And it's a beautiful day. And we're discussing all the insanities of the day's geopolitical events. And Frank does it with such wit, intelligence, and humor. And I'm looking forward to joining him for a beer at The Roost in Stonebridge, where we're gonna have an IPA and drink to the impending felony conviction of a prominent Republican president or candidate. Dreaming out loud. Thank you for dreaming with me. When you dream, you don't have to be in a rush. Let the dream unfold. Driving my car along a beach, and the ocean's on the left. And I'm on my way to a theater to do a performance, and I'm looking for a place to park. I find this mound, a high place. I park the car there. I think to myself, the tide, it's going out, it's going out. Tide is going out. Get out of my car. I go into the theater. And I'm warming up. And I'm getting ready for the performance. And I look out the window. And the ocean isn't falling. It's rising. My car is going to be submerged. Submerged. There's a film noir going on, and there's a shot of a sink, and the water's coming out of the faucet, and it's spiraling down the drain. The water is spiraling down the drain. You are spiraling down the drain. You gotta crawl on. You gotta keep crawling. Don't stop crawling. You gotta crawl to salvation. Crawl. Don't doubt it. Don't doubt, don't pout, get out. Don't pout, don't doubt, get out. Don't pout, don't doubt, get out. And now I see the elevator. In Stuyvesant Town, where I grew up, on 14th Street, Lower Manhattan. And I'm going upstairs to my family's apartment, and I get in the elevator, and all the buttons have these crazy symbols. They're not numbers or letters. We lived at 11B, but there's all this mixture of signals, and I can't seem to find the right button. And I push one button. I go up to a floor, and I go up to the door, and my family's name is not on it. It's in some foreign language. And somebody comes to the door, and they go, "Who are you? What are you doing here?" I'm dreaming. That's what I'm doing here. I'm dreaming.
Dream with me.
And as we dream, let's listen to the sound. To the sound of a dream. I can hear the dream in the room. Listen. Rolling home. Rolling home. I'm dancing. I'm dreaming. I'm dancing at Avant-Garde-Arama. At the lace mill. I'm dreaming again. I must be dreaming. I'm dreaming again. Thank you for dreaming with me. Take a brief intermission, and we'll be back with Nancy Orlovsky and Megan Gugliotta. Please stand by.
Thank you. Thank you.
on with another short film from Sally Eckhoff called The Witch. Sally Eckhoff's The Witch. I'm pleased now to introduce films by Hannah Bass with live music by Spaghetti Eastern Music. Thank you.
up, please.
As you can see, all kinds of expression happen at Avant-Garde-Arama. I just thought for a moment that I might share with you the thought that the word Avant-Garde-Arama is embedded with magical spiritual properties. And it can be used as a mantra. Could you join me for a moment just to say Avant-Garde-Arama?
Avant-Garde-Arama.
Thank you. And I'm imagining that we might collectively do a little vocal mantra of repeating the words Avant-Garde-Arama a couple of times and maybe gain a little momentum as we say it. A little energy. Please join me in the Avant-Garde-Arama mantra.
Avant-Garde-Arama. 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 Thank you. Thank you.
And in this great spirit of creativity and freedom that we hope is in the room tonight, and I think it is. As I said, there was a tradition for many years in Avant-Garde-Arama of a segment called 42nd Street. And what 42nd Street was an opening for anyone in the room to do something for 40 seconds. Tell a story. Do nothing. Sing a song. Do a dance. Anything goes. It's 42nd Street, and the floor is open for anyone who wants to take it.
I'll take it.
If anybody wants to do anything.
last I was in this room in March, Frank Boyer was here, and I just got a text that my friend Chuck Keith died, and he wrote a song, and it went like this. If he was a fish, how is he a frog? I don't know. Magically, I suppose, tadpoles must grow. To Frank and to Chuck.
Thank you. We'll have another 40 seconds of waiting.
Come on aboard the caboose of the Transvolution Times Express. Hold on tight. Gotta be worried about that whiplash. Come on aboard. There's a locomotive up front, being fueled by the vampires of Mother Earth's insulated blood.
Thank you very much.
Called birth.
Curious to spend lyrics on the verge of furious. I'm addicted to come up. See, that's why we're doing this. I got style. I surprised them the way I got up, and then I hit the studio. It's time to blow. Blow, block off. No hesitation. This information got you contemplating. Heartbreaking, eliminating with this conversation. Breaking in to see a face of emancipation, a celebration of my criminal elevation. No anticipation. On my members across the 50 states, we keep the nation anticipating and still be great. I'm addicted to come up, see that's why we're doing this. I got style.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm driving Lena nuts, who wants to do her final performance of the evening, but we're going to wait 40 more seconds. Thank you all for participating in 40 Seconds, please.
For the final act of the evening, I'm very happy to introduce Lena Azalea Devil.
Thank you.
Avant-Garde-Arama is a leader. Name on the mailing list. We'll keep you informed.
We need you.